answer at all. Why don't we lift our hands to the Most High God and begin to bless His holy name? Begin to worship Him, begin to adore Him. Give Him glory, give Him honor, give Him adoration. Bless His holy name. He's worthy to be praised. It's worthy to be adored. Magnify His holy name. Praise the King of Kings. Praise the Lord of Lords. Worship Him, worship Him. There's no one like Him. He reigns forever. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him. Give Him glory, give Him honor. Give Him adoration. Praise Him. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshipped. Now lift your voice to Him loud and clear and say, Father, from now on, let hallelujah be permanent in my mouth. Go ahead, talk to the Almighty God. Father, from now on, let hallelujah be permanent in my mouth. Everywhere I go, let hallelujah be permanent in my mouth. Every day, every night, all the days of my life, Father, let hallelujah be permanent in my mouth. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. I want you to join your hands with your neighbor and then pray this prayer. Yes, Father, please fill the mouth of my neighbor with continuous hallelujah. Fill the mouth of my neighbor with continuous hallelujah. Fill his mouth with continuous hallelujah, O Lord. Fill his mouth with continuous hallelujah, O Lord. Fill his mouth with continuous hallelujah. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. We give you all the glory. We give you honor. We give you all the glory. We give you honor. Amen. Amen. We give you all the glory. Thank you, Father. Daddy says there's someone here tonight. He said, I will heal your memory. Thank you, Almighty. The Lord said there's someone here tonight. He said your river seemed to be drying up. He said, I will give you another spring. Oh, thank you, Lord. Daddy says there's someone here tonight that your testimony will be this convention was meant for me. My Father, my God, we want to bless your name. What a wonderful God you are. Thank you for all you have done since this convention began. Thank you for what you did on Monday. Thank you for what you did on Tuesday. Thank you for what you did on Wednesday. Thank you for what you did on Thursday. Thank you for what you are already doing now. Thank you for what you will do tomorrow. Thank you because we know how to. Tomorrow will be all right. Accept our worship in Jesus' name. Father, tonight in all our lives, let there be beautiful testimonies. Let every one of us live here shouting
hallelujah.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Well, let somebody shout hallelujah. Well, shake hands with two or three people and tell them this convention is for me, you know. This convention is for me. And then you may please be seated. I'm going to read from verse 5 to 6.
5 to 6.
You're already tremendously blessed, I know that. The evangelist started the night. The bishop added his weight to that. I'm already blessed. I don't know why they asked a pastor to speak after those two mighty men. But I know they will be praying for me. Revelation 19, verses 5 and 6. And a voice came out of the throne saying, praise our God. All ye servants, and ye that fear him, both small and great.
ohun kan si ti bi ite na jade wa wi pe e ma yin olorun wa eyin iranse re gbogbo eyin ti o beru re ati ewe ati agba.
And I heard, as it were, the voice of a great multitude, and as the voice of many waters, and as the voice of mighty thunderings, saying, Alleluia, for the Lord God omnipotent reigneth.
Mosi gbo bi eni pe ohun opolopo eniyan ati bi iro mi pupo ati bi iro ara nla nla n wi pe Alleluia, nitori Oluwa Olorun wa Olodumare njoba.
Alleluia, as we have been told.
Alleluia, gege bi ati so fun wa.
Simply means,
o tumo si pe,
praise the Lord.
Eyin Oluwa logo.
And he says, everybody should praise him.
O si so pe gbogbo eniyan ni ko ma yin logo.
Small and great,
ati ewe ati agba.
Men and women,
okunrin ati obinrin.
Boys and girls,
omode lokunrin ati lobinrin.
And if you belong to any of these categories,
to ba je pe wa ni kan ninu gbogbo awon ti adaruko yi,
let me hear you shout Alleluia.
Ye ngo ko ki Alleluia.
Now, in any congregation,
ni ajo awon eniyan gbogbo,
there will always be three categories of people.
Awon ko eniyan meta ni o mo be.
There will be those who have just lost a battle.
Awon kan wa ti won je pe won sese padanu ogun ni.
Then there will be those who are in the midst of a terrific battle.
Awon kan si wa so je pe won be loju ina ogun jija.
And then, of course, there will be those who have just won a battle.
I want me to see. I want to see tomorrow to get me. What she said, "Jagun Sheguni."
And yet,
Sibe,
Psalm 47, verse 1.
Only David, only Tadini, Adota, Esekini.
Psalm 47, verse 1.
Only David, only Tadini, Adota, Esekini.
Says, clap your hands, all ye people, and shout unto God with the voice of triumph. How can God say to everybody to praise
Him?
How can I be praising Him when I've just lost a battle?
Báwo ni mo ṣe fẹ́ máa yin Olúwa nígbà tó jẹ́ pé mo ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ pàdánù ogun ni, mo ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ sí ìjákulẹ̀?
Because like the bishop told you,
gẹ́gẹ́ bí bishop ṣe sọ fún wa,
if you have lost something,
tí o bá ti pàdánù ohun kan,
it is God that didn't allow you to lose everything.
Ọlọ́run ni ò jẹ́ o pàdánù ohun gbogbo.
And so you should praise Him for whatever remains. But the major reason why those who have just lost a battle should praise God,
ṣùgbọ́n ìdí pàtàkì tó yẹ kí àwọn tí wọ́n ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ pàdánù ogun kí wọ́n fi yin Ọlọ́run,
is that when there is life, there is hope.
Òun náà ni wípé bá òkú ìṣe òtán.
Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 4.
Iwe Oluwa so orikesan ese kerin.
Ecclesiastes 9 verse 4.
Oluwa so orikesan ese kerin.
Tells us that a living dog is better than a dead lion.
O so fun wa wi pe aja to wa laye o san ju oku kini un lo.
That's why Psalm 150 verse 6.
Idini ti orin Davidi ori adoje ese kefa.
Psalm 150 verse 6 says, all things that have breath, they should praise the Lord. If you are still breathing, You should be praising God. Because as long as there is life, tomorrow can still be all right. In Judges chapter 6, Judges chapter 16, from verse 18 to 22. Samson has just lost a big battle.
Samson is a padanu ogun nla kan ni.
Delilah has shaved off his head.
Delilah ti fa orun ori e.
Handed him over to the enemy.
Won si pe fun awon ota.
They bound him.
One day,
they plucked out his eyes.
Won yo ju e mejeji.
And they were leading him down to prison.
Won si mu lo si ogba ewon.
But the Bible says his hair began to grow again. As long as you are not yet dead, there is hope for you. No matter how terrible your situation may
be,
it can be worse than that of Job. And yet Job said,
then in Job
19 verse 25,
Job 19 verse 25,
he said, in spite of everything that may be happening to me, I know my Redeemer lives. As long as you are still alive, as long as Jesus is alive, you are confident that tomorrow will still be alright. I told you the story of a young boy before.
He
was a pupil in our primary school at Ebute Metta.
Way back in 1981.
We have sent the school bus, one little school bus, to go and bring the children to school. And since the chairs were not enough, he was sitting on the dashboard of the bus, facing the driver. When they got to Ebute Metta, there was a robbery operation going on, and they were firing guns, and a bullet went through the windshield of the bus,
entered
the back of this boy, and came out through the stomach, bringing his intestines out. The teacher carried this boy to
Luth,
carrying his intestine with her hand. Because of traffic jam, they arrived at Luth about 3 hours after the accident. The doctors took a look at the boy. Meantime, he has lost almost all his blood. They saw the intestine already perforated. They felt there's no need wasting time on this. They But 1 hour passed. The boy is still breathing. 2 hours. The boy was still breathing. I think it was after 3 hours. They said, well, if he's still breathing, we can't bury him. Let's do something. That was 1981.
Although 1981, I'm sorry.
The boy has become a young man now. Healthy and strong. Serving the Lord. Because you are still breathing tonight. May I hear you shout
hallelujah.
Number 2, you have those who are in the midst of a battle. Thank you, Father. I made a request in my prayer room this afternoon. I said to mark our 65th anniversary. I want Daddy to help me heal 65,000 people
tonight.
I didn't get an answer then. But I've got an answer now. He says he will do more than that. So get ready. Don't wait till we finish. Just get ready to receive your healing now. Suppose I am in the midst of a battle. And the battle is fierce. How can I have time to be praising God? Thank God the bishop had already explained that to us. He has made my job easy. When you are fighting a battle you know you cannot win, the normal thing to do, the wisest thing to do, is to look for someone who can help you win the battle. I'm begging to come and help. In 2 Chronicles chapter 20, from verse 1 to 25, 2 Chronicles 20, 1 to 25, the bishop told us, as we read in the Bible, three mighty kings came against Jehoshaphat. Just one of them is enough to wipe out Jehoshaphat. He referred the case to the Almighty God. And the Almighty God told him, all you need to do is praise me, and I will take care of the situation. After all, the Almighty God is called the Lord. The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. He's called the Lord of hosts. Psalm 27, 24, verse 7 to 10. Psalm 24, 7 to 10. And the Bible says, if you will praise him, if you will worship him in spirit and in truth, he will draw near you. And when he draws near you, like I told you earlier, even the moment he stands, his enemies will begin to scatter. Are you fighting a battle that you know unless God helps you, you can't win? He says in Psalm 50 verse 23. He said, whosoever offers praise glorifies me. And whoever orders his conversation aright, I will show him the salvation of God. If you are fighting a battle right now, and you want to win before the sun rises, let me hear you shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I told you the story before. And thank God the man who was there that day is sitting on the altar with me. There was a wedding in one of our churches in Lagos. And it was time to sign the marriage register. Husband and wife had gone into the vestry. The husband had signed. The wife had received the pen to sign. And the husband had somebody call him, and he was the only one who heard, and he answered, and he fell down from his chair. By the time he hit the ground, he was dead. There was pandemonium in the vestry. All the pastors began to pray. They prayed in tongues, they prayed with understanding. The bridegroom got colder. After about 30 minutes, the senior pastor there remembered that I have said before, if prayer fails, try praise. So he told the people, told the pastors, stop praying. Begin to praise God. Then he ran into the church where people were wondering, what are they signing? And told them, keep on singing, keep on singing. We will join you soon. Then he dashed back into the vestry, and he joined the people praising God. You are the Almighty. You are the Lord of hosts. You have never lost a war. You are the Lion of the tribe of Judah. You are the unchangeable changer. There is no one like you. As old as you are, you have never known failure before. Suddenly, The young man on the floor sneezed. Opened his eyes. I said, what am I doing on the floor? They said, when you get up, we will tell you. Are you fighting a battle that is too difficult for you to win? And you want to be with us in December singing the song of victory? Let me hear you shout hallelujah. And then the third group.
I want you to look at that.
Those who have just won a battle.
I want you to see Bori Ninu Ogun.
Oh, thank you, Father.
Baba Eshoun.
The Lord said there's someone here tonight. He said that which you have been struggling to get will now come to you easily. Thank you, Daddy. The Lord said there's someone here tonight. He said those who are trying to hinder you from finishing your course. He said, because of you, I will finish them. This one is for me. Let me say amen to that.
Amen.
Daddy said there's someone here tonight.
Daddy said,
he said the express way of your life has been finished.
That's barrier.
Will be opened tonight.
Alei la manchi.
And that from now on,
it
will be full speed ahead. Category 3. Those who have just won a battle. Now you would think that those who have won a battle will praise God. It should be natural if you have just won a battle. I mean, in Exodus 15, verse 1 to 11. Exodus 15, verse 1 to 11. When Moses had just won a mighty battle over the army of
Pharaoh,
he sang a song unto God. In 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 1 to 10. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 1 to 10. When Hannah finally got her child, oh, she sang unto the Lord. That should be the natural thing to do. But human beings are not like that. That's why David said,
he didn't eat David if he saw his
face. In Psalm 103,
only David or he can get a lady or go room.
Psalm 103,
only David or he get a lady or go room.
From verse 1 to 5,
I said, can you see, can you?
He said, bless the Lord, oh my soul.
When you look, I walk on me.
Bless the Lord, all my soul. And all that is within me. Bless His holy name. He said, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Forget not all His benefits. Because He knows, hey, if I don't tell my soul, it will forget to bless the Lord.
Nítorí ó mọ̀ pé tí òun ò bá sọ fún Olúwa ọkàn òun, ó lè gbàgbé àti ní Olúwa.
Human nature prefers to remember bad things.
Ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ndá ènìyàn ó gbà láti máa rántí ohun tí ò dáa.
If somebody wakes up one morning weeping,
ti eyan kan ba ji to nsunkun laaro kutukutu,
and they say, why are you weeping?
Nobody ni kilo pa o lekun.
Oh, I'm just remembering my wife who died 5 years ago. Everybody will say, oh, yes, sorry.
Awon eniyan wa ba kedun pe pele ma binu.
But if somebody wakes up one morning,
ṣugbọn ti eyan kan ba ji laaro kutukutu,
and begin to shout and praise God, and they say, sir, what's happening? I'm just remembering that God gave me a miracle 2 years ago. That's why you are
still
dancing.
And
they say, we better take this fellow to the psychiatric hospital. Human beings don't want to remember good things. They prefer sad things to remember. But I know that there is someone here tonight. Even as the bishop had prophesied, from now on, you will wear a garment of praise. Thank you, Father. This word is for one particular businessman. Your business had practically crumbled. Absolutely dead. The Lord asked me to tell you, whoever you are, Lazarus will rise again.
Amen. Lazarus, yo tun ji pada.
Human beings don't want to praise God for battles they have won.
Awon omo eniyan ife dupe lowo Olorun fun ogun ti won ti bori.
And it is sad.
O si baninu je gidigidi.
Because they seem to forget that life is a series of battles.
O gbagbe pe ko ye won, tabi won ti gbagbe wi pe ile aye ogun ni.
You win one victory,
o gbori kan.
Get ready for another.
Gbaradi fun mi.
You win the second,
o tun gbori keji.
Get ready for the third.
Gbaradi fun iketa.
Let's take the case of David.
Eje abu David.
1 Samuel 17. Let's take it from verse 34 to the end.
1 Samuel 17.
From verse 34. A lion came. He killed a lion. Not long after that, a bear came.
Laipe amotekun tun wa.
He killed the bear.
O pa amotekun na.
Not long after that, Goliath came.
Laipe lai jina Goliath na su yoju.
He killed Goliath.
O be ori Goliath.
Not long after that,
like
the father-in-law came.
Baba Yahweh etuwa.
He outlived the father-in-law.
Basically, Olorenyi Baba Yahweh.
Not long after that,
like
Absalom came.
Absalom utundide.
Absalom died young.
Absalom kunirewerewe.
Not long after that,
like Elijah, no.
Adonijah came.
Adonijah not today.
How come David kept on winning?
Bawo lo se je to je pe olubori ni ewe ti Davidi ja bori.
He said,
"O with me."
In Psalm 34, verse 1.
Ni ori David ori kerin le logbon ese ikini.
Psalm 34, verse 1.
Ori David ori kerin le logbon ese ikini.
He said, "I will bless the Lord at all times.
Oni emi o ma yin Oluwa ni igba gbogbo.
His praise shall continually be in my mouth."
Iyin re yo si wa ni enu mi titi lai.
Have you won a victory?
So Seguni.
Do you want to keep on winning?
So what do I have matters? Why do you like my Seguni?
Oh, let me hear you shout
hallelujah.
I can tell you stories. I don't want to waste your time.
No, because
there are some things God wants to do.
Today I want to talk about Olorun fe se lale yi.
Anyone,
any kenny,
at all,
any kenny go to Ukori.
Whether you've just lost a battle,
oh yeah, she said, "Padanu ogun."
You are in the midst of a battle.
Abu wala ani bugu ogun.
You just won a battle.
Abu she said, "Bori ogun."
From now on,
lati sisi yi lo.
Money.
Laaro.
Afternoon.
Losan.
Evening.
Lale.
Night time.
Loru.
You should be shouting.
Hallelujah, God of Jalenu.
I'm going to give you an opportunity to shout hallelujah a couple of times.
Ma fun yin ni anfani lati ki hallelujah mu bi igba belo.
And then we'll move on to the next thing God wants me to do.
A tun wa tesiwaju si ohun to kan ti Olorun fe ki n se.
But I know some people came late.
Ṣùgbọ́n mo mọ̀ pé àwọn kan pẹ́ dé.
Probably because of the traffic.
Bóyá nítorí ọkọ̀ súnkẹrẹ gbàkẹrẹ ọkọ̀.
And they were not here when the first altar call was made.
Wọn ò sì sí níyìn nígbà tí a pè wọ́n ṣáájú lákọ̀ọ́kọ́.
Let me tell you one thing.
Ẹ jẹ́ n sọ nǹkan fún yín o.
The only person that has no hope
is the one
who hasn't got Christ.
Colossians 1, verse
27.
Colossians 1:27.
Says Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Oh no, ni ireti ogo.
If Christ is dwelling in you,
ti Kristi ba gbe inu re,
whether you have lost a battle,
boye o ti ogun ti bori e,
or you are fighting a battle,
tabo doju kogun nisisiyi,
you can rejoice.
O si le ma yo.
Because there is hope for you. So if you are here and you have never surrendered your life to Jesus, that you want him to come into your life now, so that from this moment onward, whatever may be happening, you know that your tomorrow will be all right. I want you to come forward very, very quickly. Don't drag your feet, because we don't have time to waste now. Even though I'm going to count from 1 to 20, considering how far away some of you are, I will count count fast.
Ma jara kanio.
If you have already given your life to Jesus,
so ba ti fi aye re fun Jesus nigba kan,
particularly tonight,
na le yi,
you don't need to come again.
Ma pada wa mo.
I'm just talking of the few of you who probably came late.
Mo so nipa yi die to je pe pe de ni o.
And you want to give your life to Jesus.
So ti wa fe fi aye re fun Jesus.
Come now as I count.
E ma bo, this is ibi mo tin ka.
1.
Eni.
Thank you, Father.
Baba Shu.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Ni orukola Jesu lagbadura.
Now I want you to please settle down.
Ejowo je ki a joko.
Because destinies are about to be changed now.
Nitori awon ayan mo kokan fe yi pada nisisiyi.
The Redeemed Christian Church of God, as you know,
Ijo Irapada Olorun gege bi etimo,
was started by my father in the Lord.
Baba mi ni Oluwa lo bere re.
Who practically is an illiterate.
Eni to je pe won o mo ko mo ka.
God told him he will start a church through him.
Olorun so fun won pe owo bere ijo kan pelu nipase won.
That will go around the whole world. Now that doesn't make sense. You're starting a church through somebody who cannot read or write. You say it will go around the world. But God is always true. Once he speaks, it is done. Today, we are in more than 190 nations of the world. A majority of things that happened to this church came by divine revelation to my father in the Lord.
Nipa imisi atoke wa si baba mi ni latodo Olorun na fi wa di mimu se.
For example, the name of the church
fun apere oruko ijo yi
was given to him in a vision.
Ninu iran ni ati fi han won.
God showed him a blackboard.
Olorun fi ohun ikowe patako ikowe han won
and told him to copy down what he sees.
Owo si so npe ko ko ohun to ri yen ele.
And what he saw, he wrote down.
Ohun to ri o ko le.
Remember, he couldn't speak English.
Eranti pe won o gbo yibo.
And the name,
oruko yen,
it's an English name.
O si je oruko oyibo.
The Redeemed Christian Church of God.
Ijo Irapada ti Olorun.
Now, after some time,
leyin igba die,
God showed him a vision.
Olorun tun wa fi iran kan han won
and told him to make a rod.
Wi pe ki won se opa kan.
That the rod will be made of wood in a certain fashion.
Ni gege bi Olorun se sakawe re fun won.
And he must hand over that rod to the one who will succeed him.
O si ni lati gbe igi na opa na le eni ti o gbase lowo won.
He made the rod.
Won se igi na.
I handed it over to me.
Once you have me lower.
Now there's nothing magical about the rod.
O sin kan kan to da bi alupaida lara igi na tabi opa yi.
It's completely wood.
igi lásán ni.
But he gave it to me.
Ṣùgbọ́n wọ́n fi lé mi lọ́wọ́.
As a staff of office.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọ̀pá àṣẹ.
And the reason you have not been seeing it.
Ìdí tí ẹ kì í fi rí nígbà gbogbo.
Is that God made it clear to me when I got it?
Ọlọ́run fi yé mi gbangba nígbà tí wọ́n fi lé mi lọ́wọ́ pé.
That it will not be coming out casually.
Pé kì í kàn kò kàn ní máa jáde lásán láì nídìí.
But it will come out when he says so.
Ṣùgbọ́n yóò máa jáde nígbà tí òun Ọlọ́run bá sọ bẹ́ẹ̀ pé kó jáde.
And it's out tonight.
Orin níta.
Is going to be involved in the prayers you are about to pray.
A o si lo ninu adura ti e fe gba.
Please, if you think this is childish play, just don't pray. Okay?
O ba do pe ere mode leleyi, mo gbadura o.
But he told me you are going to pray three prayers.
Ṣùgbọ́n ó sọ fún mi pé kókó àdúrà mẹ́ta lè gbà.
He said when Moses got to the Red Sea.
Pé nígbà tí Mose dé etí òkun pupa.
He told him to lift up the rod.
Ó ní pé kó gbé ọ̀pọ̀nà ọ̀pá rẹ̀ sókè.
And three things happened.
Ohun mẹ́ta ọ̀tọ̀ọ̀tọ̀ ló ṣẹlẹ̀.
Which is going to happen in the life of someone here today.
Èyí tó máa ṣẹlẹ̀ láyé ẹnìkan ní ìlálẹ̀
yìí. I will tell you the first.
Màá sọ tàkọ́kọ́ fún yín.
Then you will pray your first prayer.
À ó gbàdúrà àkọ́kọ́.
Then I will tell you the second.
Màá sọ ìkejì.
And you pray your second prayer.
À tún gbàdúrà kejì náà.
And then I will tell you the third.
Màá wá sọ ìkẹta.
And you pray your third prayer. Then finally, before we depart tonight, I'm going to raise it to anoint your handkerchiefs.
Lati fi ami ororo yan awon aso iloju yi.
An handkerchief that you cannot give to your friend.
Aṣọ ìnùjú tó lè fún ọ̀rẹ́.
Because it's going to be very, very special.
Nítorí yóò jẹ́ ohun tó ṣe pàtàkì.
Now the first time when Moses lifted up the rod.
Nígbà àkọ́kọ́ tí Mose na ọ̀pá náà sókè.
The wind of God blew.
Afẹ́fẹ́ Ọlọ́run ó fẹ́.
The first time that the wind of God blew.
Ìgbà àkọ́kọ́ tí afẹ́fẹ́ Ọlọ́run máa fẹ́.
In Genesis chapter 1.
Ní Genesis orí ìkíní.
Was when God spoke.
Òní nígbà tí Ọlọ́run sọ̀rọ̀.
And said let there be light.
Tó ní pé jẹ́ kí ìmọ́lẹ̀ kí ó wà.
And there was light.
Ìmọ́lẹ̀ sì wà.
Another time that the wind of God blew.
Ìgbà kejì tí afẹ́fẹ́ Ọlọ́run tún fẹ́.
Dry bones came back to life.
Oh no, ni awon egungun gbigbe won pada di aye.
And I thank God for the testimony we had tonight.
Bo si wa dupe lowo Olorun fun eri ta gbo lale yi.
Of the lady all the way from America.
Of ti obirin to won lati ilu America.
On 12 different kinds of drugs.
O de ti orisi ogun bi mejila lo nlo. Lojumo.
But she came here.
Won wa si yi.
The wind blew.
Afefefe.
And the irreversible was reversed.
Ohun ti o yi pada, o si yi pada.
Stand on your feet.
E dide lori ese yi.
I'm going to leave the rod.
Ma gbe opa na soke.
You will pray your first prayer.
Wa gbadura ti akoko.
If you don't believe.
To ba gbagbo.
Don't worry yourself.
Don yore elenu.
Sit down and be enjoy yourself.
Joko ni jelenke ko ma gbadun ara e.
I'm not going to lift it up for more than 2 minutes.
Mo ni gbe soke ju bi iseju meji pere lo.
Focus on it.
Sa ri daju pe o lo nwo.
And pray your prayer thus. You're going to say, Father, let your wind blow on me tonight. Where there was darkness in my life, let there be light, and reverse the irreversible. Go ahead. Father, in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The second thing that happened was that the Red Sea parted, and there was a way where there was no way before. I'm going to lift up the rod now, and your prayer will be, Father,
Baba,
make a way for me where there have been no way before. Go ahead. Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Ni orukọ nla Jesu la gbadura.
The third thing that happened,
ohun keta to sele,
is that all the enemies of Israel got drowned in one night.
Oni pe gbogbo awon ota Israeli bata lomi wo lo loju kan lojo kan.
So everything that you don't want in your life anymore are the things you are going to call on God to bury tonight. So you will lift up your voice to Him and say, Father, before the sun rises, these evil things in my life, let them become forgotten. Go ahead.
That's what you.
Them sickness, I don't want to see you again. Poverty, I don't want to see you again. Failure, I don't want to see you again. Anything called sorrow, I don't want to see you again. I don't want to see you again in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
I join my faith with yours. Tonight, the wind of God will blow on you. Where there was darkness, there will be light.
Maybe tea or kukube wa teleri, imole yo ma wambe.
Your dry bones will live again.
E kukube bere yo tupada ye.
Everything considered irreversible shall be reversed.
O kukube taro, kyo se yi pada. Patak pata lolon wa yi wapada.
And God will make a way for you. Even where there was no way before, He will make a way for you. And everything that has been causing you anxiety, causing you sorrow, sickness, failure, poverty, barrenness, they shall be buried tonight. By tomorrow morning, a new dawn will be available for you. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Now let me hear you shout hallelujah.
Hey, hallelujah.
Now let's be seated. Very quickly, we want to say thank you to God for what He has done already and for what He will yet do. And there's a particular song that I can feel in my spirit. It's a Yoruba song, but it simply says, bye bye to rubbish. Bye bye to jati jati.
That jati.
Bye bye to rede rede.
Bye bye to rede rede.
In the name of Jesus.
Bye bye to rede rede.
Okay, so we will sing that song as we give our thanksgiving offering.
Orin yen la ma ko bi o se ma dupe lowo Olorun ta ma fi ore wa le.
And then, with his permission, I will anoint your handkerchief.
Pelu igbala ye won ma wa fi ami roro yan awon aso nuju yin.
And he says,
o si wi pe,
what you will use that handkerchief for?
Ohun te ma lu aso nuju yi fun
is that any time you face a problem,
ohun gba ki gba ti ogun kogun ba doju ko yin,
you wave it in his front.
Wa juba ni waju ogun na.
You wave it in front of somebody that you have been preaching to who refused to receive Jesus.
They
will surrender. You will wave it in the front of someone that they say will never have a child.
Twins
will come forth. You wave it in the front of somebody who said they are not going to give you an appointment. Or somebody who says he will not give you a visa. Or somebody who says he will not give you admission. And there will be testimonies. So very quickly now.
Log on this to see ye.
Oh, thank you, Father.
Baba Shu.
It's a big one. Please listen carefully. Very, very carefully.
And
let me finish before you even say amen. You don't say there's someone here tonight. That is about to open to you three doors. Don't say amen yet.
My teeth are me. 30 eleko bodada.
And each one is not going to be a one-time miracle. But each one will become like a river bringing in blessings. He said the first one
only tita koko
is your own completely.
Titi eni pata pata.
Whatever is coming through that door is your own.
Tieni.
You can do whatever you like with it.
He
said the second door will be bigger than the first. And it's completely God's own. You're not to touch it.
Oh, what a forward.
It will be coming like a river flowing.
Oh no, you're my wabi odotishoni.
And he said, based on your faithfulness, there will be a third door bigger than the first two that he will share with you 50-50. He said, as long as you remain faithful for the rest of your life, the blessings will be flowing through this
readers. Oh.
And then there is this other big one. And this one surely is for me. Because he said there's someone here tonight. Before the end of this month, You will hear an exceedingly great news. Now let's take our thanksgiving offering. Dancing, rejoicing, go to the nearest basket. Let's do it quickly so that we can do the remaining thing he wants us to do and be out of here before 2 o'clock.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are
you lift up your handkerchiefs now? Take good care of this one. And I want you to just hallelujah as I wave.
Until I stop.
Titi ma video dake. You can begin now.
Hallelujah.
When you wave this handkerchief, the wind of God will blow. When you wave it, there be a way where there's no way.
Oh no, Allah, if you to summary.
When you wave it, every rubbish in your life will be blown away. The Almighty God will bless your offering. He will sanctify it. He will use it for His glory. Tonight, poverty is blown away from you. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Now, before you do the final thing,
there'll
be Holy Communion service tonight, this Saturday night. And we'll be talking on Jesus gave thanks. I've been looking forward to seeing you. Now you are, for the first time, you are going to wave your handkerchief. And so the devil. You have lost the battle now. You have lost the battle now.